in Roberto Rossellini's masterpiece, Open City. A priest allies himself with a communist and an Italian army deserter to resist the Nazi occupiers of Rome. This priest is captured and worked on by the Gestapo, who try to break him by pointing out that his allies are atheists. Before he is executed, the priest responds to his captors that anyone who works to help others is on God's path, whether they are believers or not. The Rosenfeld Gallery is currently featuring a show of abstractions by Val Rossman. Harold and Lynne Honickman are collectors of Val's work and, through the Honickman Foundation, very active in philanthropic activities in the Philadelphia region. They are key supporters of Project Home, an organization that strives to help the homeless of Philadelphia. The opening reception to Val's show was also a fundraiser for Project Home, and a percentage of the sales will be donated to that organization. In attendance that day was Sister Mary Scullion, co-founder of Project Home and one of Time Magazine's 100 most influential people in the world. When I met her, I thought immediately of the priest in Open City. I felt I was in the presence of someone close to God.
Okay, so my name is Sister Mary Scullion. I'm the co-founder of Project Home. And Project Home is a community of people from all walks of life that are committed to ending homelessness and poverty here in Philadelphia. And we do that through housing, education, employment, and medical care. Because we're a community of people from all walks of life, it includes such wonderful people as the Rossmans and the Honickmans. They invited us through their gifts and talents, which is art, Val Rossman, who's an incredible artist, to include some of the members of our community to see her work and see the show. And it's an expression of life and hope and what our world is about from her eyes. That's what it's all about. It's at Project Home, we say none of us are home until all of us are home. And And we really believe we all need one another, and we're part of that single garment of destiny. Like, we're all part of it. What affects one of us affects all of us. So it's good to mix it up a little bit.
I told Sister Mary that while I often doubt the existence of God, I've always been moved by acts of kindness. It was a magical day for me to meet these lovely, caring people. As Mary said, Val Rossman's painting is so filled with life, and Val told me how she tries to reflect the spirit of the times through her work.
I guess the idea behind this work is multi-dimension, multi-facet way of life that we lead right now, where there's five computer windows open at the same time and we're flicking back and forth and answering the phone and talking to someone else and cooking dinner, and just our lives are just compacted with so much going on all at the same time. These paintings are kind of dealing with that. At the same time, there's so much that really doesn't make sense in our world, and the smartest people in politics and literature and art can't figure it out, and science, and there's that piece going on. Plus, underneath everything, I just love color. So there's just a purely pleasurable aspect of playing with the color and balancing the color and the textures. I also love the idea of them being on the aluminum when they're complete and they're hanging here in the gallery or somewhere else. You just don't know what it is. I mean, it's this thin thing that's hanging on the wall. And it's kind of cool that it has that type of presence to it. And I love that shiny surface. And for me, when I touch them now, they're just smooth like a car. And to me, that's pretty sensuous. I love that aspect too.
It made perfect sense to me that these two remarkable women, the activist nun and the fine artist, would join forces. Val gave me her perspective on Mary and the meaning of this blessed day.
She is just a down-to-earth, incredible woman. The organization has 260 residences in Philadelphia. I believe she lives in one now, still. At one point in trying to get this housing, she went up against Rendell and won. She's a formidable force. I'm just excited to be able to partner in this situation. It's a good opportunity for both Project Home and for me, so people can invest in my artwork, and then I get a chance to donate back to this cause. Right now it's between two of the most important Jewish holidays of the year, Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, and I'm Jewish, and they're referred to as the days of awe. And I was thinking, well, isn't that kind of appropriate, because today was a day of awe to look at artwork and experience that, and I think art should evoke awe, but also Sister Mary is a person that would give people a sense of awe in terms of what she has accomplished. So
I made sure to ask Mary one final question.
If somebody who sees this movie would like to contact you to help, how do they reach you?
They could go on our webpage, www.projecthome.org, and see the multitudes of ways in which people can be involved through advocacy, changing unjust policies in our country that create homelessness, volunteering, contributing, finding all kinds of ways of getting involved.